Okay, good morning students. In a previous video, we have discussed about the process of glycolysis. Okay, you all know that our body is made up of many organ systems. Means our body consists of many organ systems. Each organ system is made up of various types of organs. Each organ is made up of tissue, cells, then cells. Up to cells, it is a very common process, but now in this chapter we have to learn about the remaining portion or the internal part of that cell. That cell contain many organs, okay, organelles, and each and every organelle contain many macromolecules. Here macro means large, theek hai, jo micro that is small, macromolecules means large molecules. In glycolysis process, glucose is completely oxidized and two molecules of pyruvic acid form. Okay, one molecule of glucose gives two molecules of pyruvic acid. Glucose, that is 6-carbon compound, but a pyruvic acid molecule is a 3-carbon compound. Now, after that glycolysis, the next process is tricarboxylic acid cycle. Tricarboxylic acid cycle is also known as Krebs cycle. Why it is known as Krebs cycle? Because the same cycle was discovered by a scientist, Sir Hans Krebs. Okay, that's why it is also known as Krebs cycle. Another name for the same cycle is citric acid cycle. Why it is known as citric acid cycle? Because when oxidation of pyruvic acid starts, after that the first stable compound is citric acid. Means citric acid is the first stable compound formed, and that's why the same cycle is also known as citric acid cycles. Means three names are here: tricarboxylic acid cycle, Krebs cycle, citric acid cycle. Tricarboxylic acid cycle, because in this whole process total three carboxylic acid groups are present, and that's why it is known as tricarboxylic acid cycle. What happened in this cycle? Pyruvic acid, which is the product of that glycolysis process. Okay, pyruvic acid is the product of glycolysis process. The same pyruvic acid is oxidized in presence of acetyl coenzyme A, and it forms citric acid. After that, the citric acid produces isocitric acid. When isocitric acid is further converted into alpha ketoglutaric acid, during this process one carbon dioxide molecule is released. Same in this process, NAD, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, is reduced to nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide hydrogenate complex, that is NADH2. Okay, when alpha ketoglutaric acid further converted into succinyl coenzyme A, again one carbon dioxide molecule is released, and again NAD is converted into NADH2. That succinyl coenzyme A further used to form succinic acid. Okay, succinyl coenzyme A further used to form succinic acid. After that, succinic acid is converted into fumaric acid. In this process, before NAD is converted into NADH2, but in this process FAD is reduced to FADH2, that is flavine adenine dinucleotide. Okay, that flavine adenine dinucleotide is reduced to flavine adenine dinucleotide hydrogenate complex. After that, fumaric acid is further converted into malic acid, and malic acid further converted into oxaloacetic acid. Again here NAD reduced to NADH2, means two molecules of NADH2 are formed here, again two molecules of NADH2 here, and two molecules of NADH2 here, total six molecules of NADH2, and here two molecules of FADH2 are formed during this Krebs cycle. Okay, the next step is electron transport chain. What happened in electron transport chain? It takes glycolysis the reason of mitochondria. Before that, glycolysis and tricarboxylic acid cycle takes place in the region of cytoplasm. But electron transport chain takes place in the region of mitochondria. Okay, only the transfer of electron takes place in this process. Due to the transfer of electron, two molecules, that is carbon dioxide and water, these two molecules are the product of that electron transport chain. In this process, what happened? Three molecules of ATP are generated with NADH2 and two molecules of ATP are generated from FADH2. Complete aerobic respiration, which includes three types of processes, that is glycolysis, tricarboxylic acid cycle and electron transport system. These three processes combinedly form total of 38 ATP molecules and which provides energy to our body. Okay, means one complete aerobic respiration gives us 38 ATP molecules, and these 38 ATP molecules provides us energy, and that's why these 38 ATP molecules are formed in mitochondria, and hence mitochondria is known as the powerhouse of cell. Okay, in next video we will discuss about the energy currency and the different food components and how we will get energy from the food. Okay, thank you so much.